Hi, let's talk about the autonomics of the gut tube. As you may recall, the autonomic nervous system has two constituents. There's the sympathetic component and the parasympathetic component. The sympathetic component is the fleeing or fighting, whereas the parasympathetic component is the rest and digest. Now, with respect to the digestive system, there are two parts of the autonomics that we want to pay attention to. There's the effect on the gut tube and motility, and then the effect on the vasculature, which serves the gut tube. Now, looking at the parasympathetic outflow to the gut tube, the foregut and the midgut are served via the vagal trunks, whereas the hindgut are served by the pelvic splanchnic nerves, which are branches of sacral nerves 2, 3, and 4. When the parasympathetics are activated to the gut tube, what we see is increased GI activity because the parasympathetics are going to be what stimulates that myenteric or intramural plexus, which is responsible for activating the muscularis layer of the gut tube. In terms of the parasympathetic's effect on the vasculature, you may recall that parasympathetics help to deactivate the sympathetics, which are vasoconstrictors, which are going to have more of a role in the paravascular plexuses. And so parasympathetics are going to be important for moving materials, whether it's the bolus of food through the esophagus or the chyme through the stomach, the small intestines and the large intestines down to the rectum where it's turned into feces. Now, the sympathetics are largely organized through pre-aortic or pre-vertebral ganglia, such as the celiac, superior mesenteric, and aortico-renal, or just the aortic plexus. The sympathetics are going to work counter to the parasympathetics, and so they're going to slow GI activity. Their largest importance are going to be through vasoconstriction. So during a flee or fight response, we're going to vasoconstrict blood flow to the gut tube so that it may be more readily available. Blood may be more readily available for skeletal muscles. In terms of the overall distribution of the sympathetics to the gut tube, the fore and the midgut are served by greater and lesser splanchnic nerves and branches of the abdominal sympathetic trunk, whereas the hindgut is served via lumbar splanchnic nerves and sacral splanchnic nerves.